Morning, and let's go ahead now and bring in Dr. Aniti Nurakar. She is a physician at Harvard Medical School, and she always brings us just the best advice and expertise. So, Dr. Nurakar, thanks for being with us again today. Let's go ahead and dive right into this question around boosters. The FDA approved Pfizer's booster for people over 65, frontline workers, and those who are immunocompromised, but we are still waiting to hear from the CDC on their recommendation. So, do you think, doctor, that limiting the booster to specific at-risk populations is the way to go, or really should we be opening it up and letting more people get a booster shot who want it or need it?
You know, what's interesting about this language that the FDA chose, Morgan, is that it is quite broad. The three groups, like you mentioned, age over 65, but high risk and increased risk of exposure are all very open to interpretation. I think by doing this, the FDA has really given the ownership of the decision of to whether to boost or not to individuals and their physicians to make. So that is a good thing.
And doctor, I mean, this emergency authorization, as we mentioned, it only does apply to Pfizer. But what about the people who got the Moderna or the Johnson & Johnson vaccine? Where do they stand? I mean, can you mix and match and get a Pfizer booster, or is that a dangerous combination?
This is a hotly debated issue right now, Morgan. Other countries like Canada, the UK, and Italy are doing the mixing of vaccines. We are not doing that yet, but we likely will. We know that early studies show a more robust immunological response with mixing, though the FDA and CDC don't have that data available for use right now here in the U.S. That may change. You know, that is very meaningful, especially to the 15 million people who received the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, who may opt for a different vaccine simply for earlier safety considerations.
All right, Dr. Aniti Nurakar, as always, thank you so much for being with us. We appreciate it.